horrific incident, a Vasco resident Chaloba Kesarkar allegedly killed his wife Vaishali Kesarkar by hitting her head with an iron rod leading to her death. The incident happened at their residence in Shantangar, Vasco. After the incident, Chaloba surrendered to the police. The Vasco police arrived at the scene and conducted further investigations into the matter. Workers engaged by the Sports Authority of Goa removed a large amount of material that was used to set up a mini golf course and discarded it after the national games held last year. This action was the result of the Herald TV news report done on 23rd May wherein tourists taking nap on derelict plywood planks fashioned into makeshift beds and wedged onto the trees at Mirmar Beach were exposed. A tourist was caught riding a private two-wheeler by the Panjim police along the DB Marg at Mirmar on Thursday. The vehicle was attached immediately and taken to the Panjim police station. A self-accident was reported at Panjim wherein a tourist driving a rental car lost control of the vehicle while attempting a U-turn on DB Road and fell into the gutter near the Abed Varia statue. Local taxi drivers rushed to help the victim and managed to tow the car out. For several days, the residents of Ghateshwar Nagar in Assagaon, Bardez, have been living in the darkness as the street lights remain dysfunctional. The absence of illumination along the streets has created hazardous conditions, with continuous traffic flow posing a serious risk of accidents. Despite numerous complaints, the authorities have turned a blind eye on this concerning issue, leaving the locals frustrated. Looking at the hit and run cases in the state and country, is it that the law is only meant for the poor and not the rich? In this edition of Street Voices, Herald TV spoke to several people regarding the same, and this is how they reacted. The Old Market Feast Shop operators met Margao Municipal Council Chief Officer and Chairperson requesting to extend the feast fair for two more days. They said that due to heavy rains in past 2 days, their business has suffered a lot. However, MMC Co. Gauri Shankwalkar denied the permission, citing the High Court order. Residents of Mapusa have raised concerns about the construction of a road divider stretching from Mapusa Circle to Mapusa Court that will pose a huge problem to the commuters due to the presence of schools and Asilo Hospital. To avoid traffic congestion in the future, the residents urged the authorities to construct the divider from the main circle to the Trimurti Hotel, to which the authorities agreed. The IMD Goa has issued a yellow alert warning till 26th May for Goa. Light to heavy rainfall is expected to shower across the state with thunder showers, lightning and winds gusting to 30 to 40 km per hour are very likely at isolated places over North Goa, South Goa districts. In recognition of World Schizophrenia Awareness Day, Cooch Mental Health Foundation orchestrated a poignant tribute at the Friday Market, underscoring the resilience and creativity of individuals battling mental illness. The foundation's stall, adorned with delectable baked goods, lush green plants, intricately painted clay pots, and captivating handcrafted paintings, served as a testament to the unwavering spirit of their clients. Vasco MLA Daji Salkar has issued a stern warning to cable operators regarding the removal of overhead and hanging cables from various nullahs in the city. Residents of Vasco have been facing significant hardships as the nullahs are getting blocked due to garbage entangling with these cables, exacerbating the issue of water drainage and causing flooding in several areas. The Feast of Mary Help of Christians was celebrated on 24th May 2024 at Don Bosco Salcona, Goa. Don Bosco Salcona, Father Anisio Mota. Father Anisio Mota was the main celebrant for the High Mass on the feast day, besides other concelebrants. In an electrifying display of skill and determination, Sirvodem Boys and Santa Cross Boys of Davolim have clinched their spots in the semi-finals of the Uprising Boys Navelim Interword Football Tournament. The thrilling matches unfolded at the Government Primary School ground in Telolim on Thursday, leaving spectators on the edge of their seats. Facing off against Rosary Boys Davolim, Sirvodayam Boys displayed grit and resilience throughout the match. Under the esteemed patronage of Captain Wenzi Vigas, MLA of the Benolim constituency, the KLCA committee tournament witnessed an electrifying football final at Vaddi Ground. In a nail-biting match, Varka veterans emerged triumphant over Serolim veterans with a narrow 1-0 victory, captivating the spectators with their prowess on the field. From the kickoff, both teams exhibited a fervent desire to seize an early advantage, igniting a fast-paced and dynamic contest. Red Bull Telolim defeated Politics Boys MES by 1-0 and entered the final of the Uprising Trophy Navelim Interword Football Tournament at Government Primary School Telolim Navelim Ground on Friday. Welroy Ribello of Red Bull Telolim netted the match winner.